Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
A blessed All Saints Day to one and all. Welcome to everyone worshiping with us in person, and welcome to all those near and far joining us through electronic means. Welcome and God's blessings to all. Quite a few announcements to pass along today. First of all, a reminder that once again, next Sunday, we have that great and exciting event that we all wait throughout the year for with bated breath. You guessed it, it's the congregation's annual meeting. Try to contain your enthusiasm. But a reminder that yes, we do have the annual meeting next Sunday right after church. Please do plan to be here if you can, to participate in the conversation and to vote. It's a very important step in our congregation's life together. So please do mark your calendars and plan to be here for that next Sunday, right after church. On All Saints Day, we remember those of our number who have died in the past year. We have 12 members of our congregation whom we have laid to rest since last All Saints Day, and we have had quite a few non-members as well who we have cared for as the end of their life has approached and whom we have accompanied on their journey into eternal rest. So we remember them all, whether named or not, and we hold them and their families in our prayers. I have two unfortunate announcements to make on that score. First, on this coming Friday, we will complete the holdover of funerals that were delayed during the COVID shutdown, when we will lay our beloved Jean Snyder to rest. So please do plan to be here on Friday at 2, if you can, to surround her family with your prayers. And please do remember her and her family in your prayers if you can't be here. May Jean rest in peace and rise in glory. We also received word this past Sunday afternoon that a gentleman who had been a member of our congregation long ago, George Early, died at the age of 90. And so we had his funeral this past Thursday over at Buse Funeral Home. May George also rest in peace, and may his family find peace. On a happier note, we get to celebrate today baptizing Charlotte Madison and welcoming three new members to our congregation. We welcome Dominic, Bee, and Christopher. Christopher is not able to be with us in person today, so he is joining us through electronic means, and we look forward to welcoming him in person when the opportunity arises. But welcome to all, and we pray that God's love will surround all our new members as their journey with us unfolds. A couple of other worship reminders for today. First of all, because All Saints' Day is a baptismal feast, we begin during the opening hymn by sprinkling everyone with baptismal water. And as you all know, I tend to be as generous with sprinkling the water as I am with talking about food. So please be warned that you will feel the droplets of water hit you. And if you feel so moved, it's customary when the water hits you to make the sign of the cross in remembrance of your baptism. But know that God's love is rained down on you and on all who have been baptized. And a reminder as well, particularly for our guests, when we distribute Holy Communion, when you come forward, please do not reach up and take the bread, but please receive it the way we all learn to do in confirmation class. Please hold your hands out, and myself or the assisting minister will drop the bread into your hand. And then please wait to eat it until you are back in your seat, so that we don't have to worry about anyone taking masks off at close quarters for everyone's safety. One other note for two Sundays from now, you may remember we had to delay Amanda Gettle's confirmation because she was exposed to the virus and was in quarantine. She will be out of quarantine safely soon, and so we look forward to confirming her on November 15th, and we will celebrate with her then. A reminder as well to please keep your eye on Palm's website, particularly as the annual meeting draws near. There's plenty of information that will be posted. And if you or somebody in your family does not use the internet or does not have regular access to the internet, please do connect by phone and make sure that we all know what's going on. We've done a beautiful job these past almost 8 months now of communicating. Let's keep it up as we go into the winter together. That's all the announcements I have. Is there anything that's not printed that we need to talk about? If not, please rise and let us begin with confession and forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, in whose image we are made, who claims us and calls us beloved. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Holy One, we confess that we are not awake for you. We are not faithful in using your gifts. We forget the least of our siblings. We do not see your beautiful image in one another. We are infected by sin that divides your beloved community. Open our hearts to your coming. Open our eyes to see you in our neighbor. Open our hands to serve your creation. Amen. Beloved, we are God's children, and Jesus, our beloved, opens the door to us. Through Jesus, you are forgiven. By Jesus, you are welcome. In Jesus, you are called to rejoice. Let us live in the promises prepared for us from the foundation of the world. Amen. Let us hum together our gathering hymn. Of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. Almighty God, you have knit your people together in one communion in the mystical body of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Grant us grace to follow your blessed saints in lives of faith and commitment, and to know the inexpressible joys you have prepared for those who love you. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. I invite the congregation to be seated and the baptismal party to gather at the font. In baptism, our gracious Heavenly Father frees us from sin and death by joining us to the death and resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. We are born children of a fallen humanity. By water and the Holy Spirit, we are reborn children of God and made members of the church, the body of Christ. Living with Christ and in the communion of the saints, we grow in faith, love, and obedience to the will of God. I invite the sponsors to present the candidate. By saying, I present Charlotte Madison for baptism. And a question for her parents. Called by the Holy Spirit, trusting in the grace and love of God, do you desire to have Charlotte Madison baptized into Christ? And the answer we're looking for is, we do. As you bring Charlotte Madison to receive the gift of baptism, you are entrusted with responsibilities to live with her among God's faithful people, to bring her to the Word of God and the Holy Supper, to teach her the Lord's Prayer, the Creed, and the Ten Commandments, to place in her hands the Holy Scriptures, and nurture her in faith and prayer, so that Charlotte Madison may learn to trust God, proclaim Christ through word and deed, care for others and the world God made, and work for justice and peace. Do you promise to help your child grow in the Christian faith and life? If so, answer, we do. Sponsors, do you promise to nurture Charlotte in the Christian faith as you are empowered by God's Spirit and to help her live in the covenant of baptism and in communion with the church? If so, answer, we do. And you, people of God, do you promise to support Charlotte Madison and to pray for her in her new life in Christ? We invite the assembly to stand for the profession of faith. I ask you to profess your faith in Christ Jesus, reject sin, and confess the faith of the church. Do you renounce the devil and all the forces that defy God? Do you renounce the powers of this world that rebel against God? Do you renounce the ways of sin that draw you from God? Do you believe in God the Father? I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God? In Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. Do you believe in God the Holy Spirit? I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Holy God, holy and merciful, holy and mighty, you are the river of life. You are the everlasting wellspring. You are the fire of rebirth. Glory to you for oceans and lakes, for rivers and streams. Honor to you for cloud and rain, for dew and snow. Your waters are below us, around us, above us. Our life is born in you. You are the fountain of resurrection. Praise to you for your saving waters. Noah and the animals survived the flood. Hagar discovers your well. The Israelites escape through the sea, and they drink from your gushing rock. Naaman washes his leprosy away, and the Samaritan woman will never be thirsty again. At this font, holy God, we pray. Praise to you for the water of baptism and for your word that saves us in this water. Breathe your spirit into all who are gathered here and into all creation. Illumine our days, enliven our bones, dry our tears, wash away the sin within us, and drown the evil around us. Satisfy all our thirst with your living water, Jesus Christ, our Savior, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Invite the congregation to be seated. Hold this one. Now you hold her over the font. There you go. Charlotte Madison, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Together let us say, you belong to Christ, in whom you have been baptized. Alleluia. Let us pray. We give you thanks, O God, that through water and the Holy Spirit, you give your daughters and sons new birth, cleanse them from sin, and raise them to eternal life. Sustain Charlotte Madison with the gift of your Holy Spirit, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord, the Spirit of joy in your presence, both now and forever. Amen. We're almost done. Charlotte Madison, child of God, you have been sealed by the Holy Spirit and marked with the cross of Christ forever. Amen. I invite the family to receive the candle. Jesus said, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will have the light of life. Let us welcome the newly baptized. We welcome you into the body of Christ and into the mission we share. Join us in giving thanks and praise to God and bearing God's creative and redeeming word to all the world. And the family may extinguish that candle and then return to your seats. And we continue with the children's time.
Boys and girls and young at heart, good morning.
Good morning.
I thought I'd make a cake. And as I was bringing this in, quite a few people, I think I whetted their appetites because they saw my ingredients here. So I was going to not bake it from scratch, but I was going to use a box cake because it's easier. And so I went and bought some cake mix, makes a butter golden delicious moist cake mix. But I wasn't sure how to make it. And I thought, well, maybe if I just dump this in a pan and maybe put it in the oven, I'd get a cake. But then I looked a little bit more closely and I needed some other things to go with this. So luckily I did have some water, it calls for some water. So I got that. It also calls for some butter, and I got butter as well. And then it calls for some eggs, and I do have some eggs, so I think I was ready. But I still wasn't sure what to do, how much water, how many eggs, how much butter. And I looked in the box and it actually gave me some instructions. And that was the recipe to how to bake this cake. So I know I needed a pan, I needed to preheat the oven, because I didn't know, do I need it at 600 degrees, 100 degrees, I didn't know. So you look on the box here, and it gives that recipe as exactly how to make it, and it made it so easy. Well, in today's lesson, we are going to hear about a recipe that Jesus has for us. It was a recipe of how to live a happy life. So in the book of Matthew, the Bible says that Jesus said, it says, "Now when Jesus saw the crowds, he went up on a mountainside and sat down. He taught them a lesson, these disciples that were following him, and we call that the Beatitudes." Well, each one of the Beatitudes starts with the words, "Blessed are they." Well, some translations of the Bible use the word happy instead of blessed. So this is Jesus' recipe for us to be happy. Well, I like the word Beatitudes because it has two parts, be and attitude. So the Beatitudes are a way that we can be and attitudes that we can have. So let's look at a few of those Beatitudes. Well, Jesus said, be merciful to people. Be kind when they are hurting. Jesus said, be peacemakers when people are fighting. Jesus said, have an attitude of pure thoughts. And Jesus said, have an attitude of wanting to do the right thing. Jesus also said that when we are sad, God comforts us, and there we are to be happy. Well, I like that Jesus gave us a recipe for how to be and what kind of attitudes to have. And Jesus said that we will be happy if we follow this recipe. Just if I follow this recipe to make a cake, I'll have a delicious cake to eat later. Let us pray. Dear God, thank you for the Beatitudes. Please help us follow your recipe for a happy and blessed life. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
The first reading is from Revelation chapter 7. After this, I looked, and there was a great multitude that no one could count, from every nation, from all tribes and peoples and languages, standing before the throne and before the Lamb, robed in white, with palm branches in their hands. They cried out in a loud voice, saying, "Salvation belongs to our God who is seated on the throne and to the Lamb." And all the angels stood around the throne and around the elders and the four living creatures, and they fell on their faces before the throne and worshiped God, singing, "Amen, blessing and glory and wisdom and thanksgiving and honor and power and might be to our God forever and ever. Amen." Then one of the elders addressed me, saying, "Who are these robed in white, and where have they come from?" I said to him, "Sir, you are the one that knows." Then he said to me, "These are they who have come out of the great ordeal. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. For this reason, they are before the throne of God and worship him day and night within his temple. And the one who is seated on the throne will shelter them. They will hunger no more and thirst no more. The sun will not strike them, nor any scorching heat. For the Lamb at the center of the throne will be their shepherd, and he will guide them to springs of the water of life, and God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We will now read responsibly Psalm 34. I will bless the Lord at all times. The praise of God shall ever be in my mouth.
I will glory in the Lord. Let the lowly hear and rejoice.
Proclaim with me the greatness of the Lord. Let us exalt God's name together.
I sought the Lord, who answered me and delivered me from all my terrors.
Look upon the Lord and be radiant, and let not your faces be ashamed.
I called in my affliction, and the Lord heard me and saved me from all my troubles.
The angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear the Lord and delivers them.
Taste and see that the Lord is good. Happy are they who take refuge in God.
Fear the Lord, you saints of the Lord, for those who fear the Lord lack nothing.
The lions are in want and suffer hunger, but those who seek the Lord lack nothing that is good.
O Lord, you redeem the life of your servants, and those who put their trust in your will not be punished. The second reading is from 1 John chapter 3. See what love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God, and that is what we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we be has not yet been revealed. What we do know is this: when he is revealed, we will be like him. We will see him as he is, and all who have this hope in him purify themselves just as he is pure. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew, the 5th chapter.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and taught them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven. For in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
All Saints' Day is the perfect time to watch a movie called Coco. If you've never seen it, it's the story of a young Mexican boy named Miguel. Inadvertently, while preparing to celebrate the Day of the Dead, which happens at this time of year as well, he magically transports himself to the land of the dead and winds up meeting several generations of his ancestors, long since gone. To find his way home, before sunrise, he has to receive the blessing of his great-great-grandparents, Hector and Imelda.
There's only one issue. In order to do that, Hector and Imelda have to talk politely to each other, something they haven't done in at least 100 years. In fact, most of the time throughout the movie, his great-great-grandmother is reminding her husband that she's still mad, even after so much time has passed. There's one point where she refers to Hector as the love of her life. Touched, he answers, "I am the love of your life?" She yells back, "I don't know, I'm still angry at you." I won't spoil the rest of the movie for you, but I do think you need to watch it. Suffice it to say, Miguel learns quite a few lessons that night during the movie. He learns how important it is to remember and to pass down the stories of those whom we love. He learns as well that it's rather wise to settle arguments in this life, because who we are in this life endures in the next. The movie was never intended to do Christian theology, but it's hard not to resonate with that same sentiment. After all, that's the whole point of All Saints' Day. Once a baptized child of God, always a baptized child of God, even in death. The reading from Revelation is here to vouch for that. Here's a fun fact for you. Despite what a certain book series of recent decades tells us, the white-robed host of Revelation are not those who will be murdered by some supervillain at the end of time. No, these are those who have already been martyrs, already have been witnesses for the faith, some paying with their lives. By the time that John of Patmos wrote this, only about 65 years after Christ's earthly ministry. It would get worse in another century or two, when to be Christian warranted a death sentence. But whether they died a martyr's death or simply reached the end of their earthly pilgrimage, as we all will, Christians were still dying. John, as a Christian bishop, had the responsibility of comforting the members of his seven churches, who wept as they laid the holy dead to rest, wondering how long it would be until Christ returned and they could see each other once more. Comfort them, he certainly did. The hymns that the martyrs and the angels are singing in this text were the same ones that these early Christian communities were already singing Sunday after Sunday. Every time they celebrated Eucharist, they prayed alongside this white-clad band, all of whom were there with them around the table. They just couldn't see them. Whenever they baptized a new Christian, they dressed them in that same white robe, proclaiming that this newborn child of God was one of them and always would be. Someday they would be able to see those who had gone before them into death face to face. Better yet, they would meet face to face the Christ who has gone before us into death and lived to talk about it, ensuring that our fate and his will be the exact same. Then they and we would sing together in one eternal Alleluia at the Lamb's wedding feast, of which Revelation later writes. Until then, they were still held together, even with those beyond human sight. That's what made them All Saints, and it's certainly good news. I promised you no more spoilers from that movie, but I lied. You get one more. Toward the end of the movie, Miguel manages to change his great-great-grandmother's mind. Before then, whenever she tried to send him home, she would say that she gave him her blessing to go home and to never play his music again, because that was a real problem in their family's past. Now, she gave him her blessing to go home and to never, she said, never forget how much your family loves you. That goes for you, Charlotte, on your baptismal day. That goes for Dominic and for Bea and for Christopher as they become members here. That goes for all of our beloved who have died since last November. And it goes for all of us. Never forget how much your family loves you. Your family that we call the body of Christ, the church. Never forget the love of the ones who have cheered you on from your first breath, who now rest beyond mortal sight. We call them the cloud of witnesses. Never forget that once a baptized child of God, always a baptized child of God. Never forget that your fate will be the same as that of Jesus Christ, in that you too, all of us, will rise from the dead to feast forever at the Lamb's banquet. That's the promise of baptism, a promise that nothing can take away, not even death. But if you need a reminder, come to Christ's table. The risen one himself will be here to embrace you and to remind you that he will never forget how much he loves you and always will. The saints at rest will be here as well, because Christ will be here. And where he is, there we all will be. Taste and see. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. I invite those who will be joining us to come forward to the altar rail. And as I mentioned, Christopher is not able to be with us in person today, but we will welcome him in person when the opportunity allows. In the meantime, we rejoice to welcome Bea and Dominic. You can stand over here. And I present to you Bea Schaefer, Christopher Kaur, even though we can't see him, and Dominic Pavone, who desire to make public affirmation of their baptism. Let us pray. Merciful God, we thank you for these brothers and this sister, whom you have made your own by water and the word in baptism. You have called them to yourself, enlightened them with the gifts of your Spirit, and nourished them in the community of faith. Uphold your servants in the gifts and promises of baptism, and unite the hearts of all whom you have brought to new birth. We ask this in the name of Christ. Amen. The two of you have made public profession of your faith, as has Christopher from a distance. Do you intend to continue in the covenant that God made with you in holy baptism, to live among God's faithful people, to hear the word of God, and share in the Lord's Supper, to proclaim the good news of God in Christ through word and deed, to serve all people following the example of Jesus, and to strive for justice and peace in all the earth? If so, please answer, I do, and I ask God to help and guide me. And you, people of God, do you promise to support these brothers and this sister and pray for them in their life in Christ? Two of you may kneel. Let us pray. We give you thanks, O God, that through water and the Holy Spirit, you give us new birth, cleanse us from sin, and raise us to eternal life. Father in heaven, for Jesus' sake, stir up in Bea and in Dominic and in Christopher the gift of your Holy Spirit. Confirm their faith, guide their life, empower them in their serving, give them patience in suffering, and bring them to everlasting life. Amen. We give you thanks, O God, that through water and the Holy Spirit, you give us new birth, cleanse us from sin, and raise us to eternal life. Stir up in these sisters and brothers the gift of your Holy Spirit, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord, the Spirit of joy in your presence, both now and forever. Amen. And I invite the two of you to rise and to face the assembly. Let us rejoice with these brothers and sisters in Christ. We rejoice with you in the life of baptism. Together we will give thanks and praise to God and proclaim the good news to all the world. Let us welcome our new members. And you may be seated, and we will continue with the prayers of intercession. Please rise for the prayers.
Let us pray. Longing for Christ's reign to come among us, we pray for the outpouring of God's power on the church, the world, and all in need. Lord of all the saints, we praise you for evangelists and martyrs whose sacrifices witness to your gospel across time and space. Inspire us by their courage to carry our faith to new people and places around us. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Lord of every place, the universe proclaims your greatness from generation to generation. Bless the work of naturalists, conservationists, and park rangers who train our attention to the wonders of the world you have made. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Lord of every nation, guide this country, red states and blue states, rural voters and urban voters, young and old, as we share in another national election. Kindle hearts eager to understand our common needs and seek our common good. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Lord of every blessing, your Son's blessing came to those living with poverty, grief, hunger, thirst, and persecution. Shape our vision of the saints to match his own. Awaken in us your call to serve all who suffer. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Lord of every venture, anoint us with the missionary spirit of the Holy Church. Bless all new missions of our synod. Empower testimony from new communities of faith to shape a diverse witness to your saving power. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Lord of every time, countless are the multitudes you have called by name and gathered to yourself. Comfort us as we grieve those who have died in the past year. Carrie, Gerald, Evelyn, Barbara, Michelle, Jean, Roberta, Martha, Jenny, Kathy, Judith, and George. In faith, may we join with them in ceaseless praise. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Receive our prayers in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior, until that day when you gather all creation around your throne, where you will reign forever and ever. Amen.
The peace of Christ be with you always. Remaining where you are and sharing a greeting without touching, let us offer one another a sign of peace. Peace be with you. Thank you.
Let us pray. God of all goodness, generations have turned to you, gathered around your table, and shared your abundant blessing. Number us among them, that as we gather these gifts from your abundance and give thanks for your rich blessings, we may feast upon your very self and care for all that you have made. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and servant. Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. And so, with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Mighty and merciful Lord, heaven and earth are full of your glory. In great love, you sent to us Jesus, your Son, who reached out to heal the sick and suffering, who preached good news to the poor, and who, on the cross, opened his arms to all. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people, for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering, therefore, his death, resurrection, and ascension, we await his coming in glory. Pour out upon us the spirit of your love, O Lord, and unite the wills of all who share this heavenly food, the body and blood of Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom, with you and the Holy Spirit, be all honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. There is a place for you at this banquet. Come and feast at Jesus' table. Thanks be to God. Christ given for you. The body of 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 Christ given for you. Given for you. The body of Christ 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 given for you. Given for you. The body of Christ 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 given for you. Given for you. The body of Christ given for you. Given for you. Amen. The body and blood of our Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in God's grace. Amen.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus, in this simple meal you have set a banquet. Sustain us on the journeys. Strengthen us to care for the least of your beloved children, and give us glad and generous hearts as we meet you on the way. Amen. Amen.
May the God of all creation, in whose image we are made, who claims us and calls us beloved, who strengthens us for service, give you reason to rejoice and be glad. The blessing of God, sovereign Savior and Spirit, be with you today and always.
Amen.
Let us hum together our closing hymn.
Serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.